Hello and welcome to the second University of Cumbria video regarding the apprenticeship management system called APTEM. In this video, we're going to be going through the signing of the key compliance documents required by the Education and Skills Funding Agency in order for your apprenticeship to be funded. The two documents that we're going to look at are the commitment statement, otherwise known as the learning plan, and the apprenticeship agreement, and both are required to be signed prior to the start date of the apprenticeship. The commitment statement contains details such as the program outline, any learning support needs that you may have identified, any functional skills needs if you don't already have relevant qualifications, and the responsibilities of the apprentice, employer, and university. It also contains the key dates of occurrences in the apprenticeship, the off-the-job learning hour requirements, and the complaints process. And this must be signed by the university, the employer, and the apprentice before the start date of the programme. The apprenticeship agreement is actually a legal requirement of the Apprenticeship, Skill, Children and Learning Act 2009, and this sets out the apprenticeship name, the place of work, and key dates, and this must be signed by the apprentice and the employer before the start date of the programme. When you next log into APTEM, you'll be presented with this screen that says Documents and the Finish button. And when you click on this, it'll first take you into the apprenticeship agreement, which looks like this. I've already pre-signed this on behalf of the apprentice, and it contains your name, the name of the apprenticeship standard, the place of work, start date for the apprenticeship, start date of the practical period, which should be the start date of the apprenticeship as well, but this is the period during which you're learning and developing practical skills in the workplace. The end date of the apprenticeship, which is when you're expected to take the endpoint assessment, and what's called the end of the practical period, which is the gateway date. So this is the point at which learning is completed and you then prepare to take the endpoint assessment. It also sets out the duration for the practical period, which is 104 weeks, and the planned amount of off-the-job learning hours. And there are notes below that describe the off-the-job learning hours and what's relevant to that. So once you sign it, it'll record the date when you signed it, and once your employer signs it, it'll record the date when they sign it as well. And that's signed by clicking in a box, and it'll add the signature that you created earlier. The next document is the commitment statement, and this contains a lot of the same information that's in the apprenticeship agreement, but also a lot more. So again, we have the program name and the apprenticeship standard at the top, the same dates and the duration in weeks, and then we have other details such as key milestones. So for example, if you were on the project management apprenticeship, within the project management apprenticeship, you also have to take a qualification known as the APM PMQ. And that would be recorded here. It's a project management qualification, and it sets a target date for that. If you come in to the apprenticeship with any recognised prior learning, which all paramedic apprentices do, that will be recorded here, and it will show the reduction in duration. So, for example, all paramedic apprentices are coming onto the programme in year two of a three-year programme. It shows the initial assessment that for your functional skills level of ability as conducted in the BKSB assessment during the onboarding wizard. And then it sets out the responsibilities of the training provider, which is the university, your employer, and the apprentice. So this is what you're expected to do. So for example, you need to plan and identify learning activities needed to support the 20% off the job learning. There are details of how we would resolve problems. So there's an issues, appeals and complaints procedure, and there are links to the relevant University of Cumbria websites where you can find out more details about making a complaint or appeals. The thing that needs to be pointed out here is that as the programme is funded by the Education and Skills Funding Agency, if you exhaust all other routes of complaint and appeal and you're still not satisfied, you can then escalate this to the ESFA using either this telephone number or this website, but they will expect you to be able to demonstrate that you've exhausted all other routes beforehand. There are then the details of the actual program content. So this contains the modules, the number of planned off-the-job learning hours involved in undertaking that module, and the details of how we'll conduct tripartite reviews. So the first one will be conducted within 4 weeks, as shown here, and that's to set objectives to get you going with portfolio building and what you need to achieve in the workplace, as well as learning through lectures. And it sets dates when we will undertake tripartite reviews with you during the apprenticeship. Sets out the planned date of the endpoint assessment and the endpoint assessment organisation, which will be the University of Cumbria. And then there are signatures here. So the university will already assign this when they create it in this box over here. The apprentice will tick into a box here, and then the employer will also have a box to tick when they log into the system to tick it. If you have any issues with the completion of the documents, or there is anything incorrect, please contact us at aptem@cumbria.ac.uk and we will deal with this. Once you've actually completed the document and you save it, it then gives you access to the full Aptem dashboard, which you'll be able to see here on the left hand side. So things such as your skills radar report, any messages that you received. The navigation of the dashboard will be covered in a later video. Thank you very much.